Nothing makes a statement quite like designer jewelry or a classic timepiece, which is why I'm always browsing LuxuryBazaar.com for affordable options and one-of-a-kind accessories. Thank you to Luxury Bazaar for sponsoring today's video. Their website will be linked down below. Hey beauties, welcome back. Today's video is a preview of the Chanel Le Beige Summer Glow collection that is coming up next. I also have the inside scoop on everything else that is launching for the first half of 2020, and we're gonna talk about it all, why not? So if you do not like spoilers, this video is not for you. Click away as quickly as possible before it is too late. If you're like me, you hate surprises, you love to know what's coming, sneak peeks, you like to plan out your purchases, or you're just plain curious, I don't blame you, then today we're gonna have so much fun taking a look at everything that is launching soon from Chanel. I'll be using my phone for reference throughout the video, so you'll have to pardon me if I'm looking down to read something, but I'm going to pop up on the screen all photos that I have, that way you can see what I'm seeing. So let's begin with the Le Beige Summer of Glow collection coming out so soon. Highly anticipated ever since pictures started leaking on Instagram. So I've seen a couple of these items and I cannot wait for this to come. It looks like it's shipping out to retailers sometime in June, but it will be available on Chanel.com and the beauty boutiques sometime in March, so any minute now. The first item is called the Healthy Glow Bronzing Cream. This is going to be an inline rebranding of the original Soleil Tan de Chanel. It says, same packaging, same formula, it's just called something different. So it will no longer be called Soleil Tan de Chanel. This was called a makeup base. Yes, this was the bronzing makeup base. Now it is simply called Healthy Glow Bronzing Cream. Same price, it looks like it's the same packaging. Instead of the gold CC on the top, it's gonna have a beige CC because it looks like it'll be part of this Le Beige collection. The shade is the same, it's universal. So it's a light gel cream bronzer, velvet finish, natural sun-kissed glow, it's buildable, lightweight. I imagine you can use it the same way. So even though this was called a makeup base, a lot of people would use this as a cream bronzer. So it makes sense that they sort of rebranded it based on what consumers would use it for. But you can still use this as a makeup base if you have a little bit more of a tan and you maybe don't like to bronze. You could buff this on your face beneath your foundation. You could wear it on top of your foundation. You really can still use it exactly the same way. It's just going to be called something different and it'll look a little bit different. But this is not going to be limited edition. This is going to stick around. When I saw pictures of this with the collection, I was a bit curious. I wasn't sure if they were gonna bring out something new, maybe expand the shade range. That's the one complaint I've heard about this product, even though it is considered to be a universal bronze. Of course, we all know that the world is made up of a multitude of skin tones, and while this works for a lot of people, for some, this just matches their skin. It's not going to bronze at all. So I wish that they were expanding the shade range, but perhaps because they are bringing this into the Le Beige collection, maybe one day in the future we will see more shades of this. But at least now we can all breathe a collective sigh of relief knowing that this is not going anywhere. This next piece of the collection I am incredibly excited about, it's the Sheer Healthy Glow Highlighting Fluid. So this used to be the Soleil Tan de Chanel Liquid Illuminator in the shade Sunkissed. They are repackaging this, it's also going to be an inline rebranding, so it's not limited edition. It will retail for the same price, $50, they're keeping Sunkissed, and they're adding a new shade called Pearly Glow. Based on the photo, it looks really beautiful, and it's in the same packaging as the Rosy Light Drops. So praise the Lord that they added a pump on this god-awful thing. That was my one complaint about this packaging was, you know, it's very cute, the big glass bottle, but it was nearly impossible to get product out of this. I mean, really bad. You basically just had to pour it on your hand and try to be as careful as possible while pouring it. Really bad. So now it has a pump, just like the Rosy Light Drops. These shades look amazing, so the Sunkissed will be the same. It says it's the same formula as well, so it's a lightweight, reflecting pigments, iridescent, luminous and healthy glow for face and body. You've probably heard me say this a million times, but I love to mix this into my foundation. You can mix it into your primer, body lotion. You can do so much with a liquid. You could just tap it on your cheeks directly if you like to use this as a highlight. So I love that they're gonna have those two shades. Again, the packaging is a transparent glass pump with a beige CC logo instead of the gold. Because the texture is a lightweight gel, the Sunkissed was never too dark, but it definitely leaned more bronze. So if you had a medium or deeper skin tone, this always was perfect for you. Whereas if you were very fair, this may not have worked. So it's nice that they're gonna offer two different shades. We have options. Here's some good news. The only piece of this collection that's limited edition is the compact powder. Everything else is going to be permanent. Just now, I was reading through the information. They're calling this the Healthy Glow Illuminating Powder. My first reaction was not happy or excited. Illuminating powder?
Illuminating powder? No.
I don't think it is a true illuminating powder. From further reading, I think this is just going to be kind of a new version of the Luminous Lay Beige powder. It looks exactly the same. So it says it's a sheer, highlighting, lightweight bronzing veil, a smooth, airy cream to powder texture. It's enriched with a unique blend of translucent pigments. It will come in exclusive packaging. It looks really pretty. There's this Rope CC logo on top. There's a surface imprint of the rope wrapped in a spiral, and then the same nautical rope design on the outer packaging. So it's definitely very cruise. And the shades are Sand, which is light medium, and Sunset, which is deep. So I don't really know how to go with this. If it's the same as a Luminous Lay Beige, I like to use that powder as my bronzer. So in that case, I would pick up Sunset. The Sand would be nice as maybe a slightly luminous setting powder. I have two shades in the Luminous Lay Beige. I have light and medium. So I imagine with this, I could do Sand and Sunset. If you're gonna use it as a bronzer, the Sand is gonna be too light. The Sunset would be the way to go. If you want a setting powder, I would go for Sand. I love the design on top. It looks really pretty. These are going to retail for $62. And again, it's the only piece that's limited. I can't help but get flashbacks from last year's cruise collection, the little duos that were supposed to be a bronzer highlight, and the one was basically a powder highlight. Nobody could use that for a bronzer. At least some people did say that, oh, it's dark enough for me to use as a bronze. But I kind of laughed thinking about that powder because it was a bit of a disaster. So many people were disappointed that it wasn't actually a bronzer. This one, it looks pretty clear cut. One of them is a bronzer and the other one is not. Next, we have eyes, lips, and nails. All of these are permanent. There's a new Healthy Glow Natural Eyeshadow Palette in the shade Warm. I'm not sure about this. They already have light, medium, and dark. These retail for $65. The Little Lay Beige eyeshadow palettes are not my favorite thing. I think I picked up probably the medium. I picked one up, I think 2 years ago they launched. They're a softer formula. It's more of a baked eyeshadow, very, very light. They are not really pigmented, or at least the ones that I've seen are not pigmented. I don't know if they changed anything with this new one. It says silky texture with high color intensity. We'll see. I'm not really sold, I'm not sure. So this has a new coral shade range. I love the shades, they're beautiful. I'm a little bit biased because I dropped my palette and it shattered into a million pieces. So I didn't have the best overall experience with mine, but I do remember that was a common complaint with this eyeshadow palette. If you love very minimal makeup, very soft, light, 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 This is perfect for you, but if you're somebody who wants your eyeshadows to really blend and build and create more, not even more dramatic, but you just like pigmented shadows, I don't think this formula is necessarily their best. There's also a new Healthy Glow lip balm in the shade Warm. These retail for $25. It's a basic lip balm. This one has a bit of a coral tint, so that'll be really pretty. And then the two nail polishes are gorgeous. There's an orange and a red, Cruise and Sailor. I think I might have to pick up that orange nail polish. So far from this collection, I'm definitely picking up both illuminators. I could skip Sunkissed, but this one is so old, disgustingly old. I'm embarrassed to tell you how old this is. I will swatch this for you guys. I will not put this on my face. So I'm gonna pick up a new version of that. Definitely picking up the bronzer. I may end up getting the eyeshadow palette. Curiosity is gonna nip me because it says it's high color intensity, and by gosh, I wanna test it for myself. So I don't have high hopes, but I will probably end up getting that, maybe the lip balm, and that orange nail polish. That looks really pretty. I love their cruise collections, their summer pieces. They're always so beautiful and sort of like refreshing makeup. That's all I have for the Summer Glow collection, but that's not it for makeup. They're also coming out with new shades of their loose powder, which I think is really interesting. So it says there are 4 existing shades and they're adding 3, discontinuing 2. At any Chanel counter I've ever visited, there have always only been 3 shades. So perhaps you guys live in an area where they've had multiple shades of the loose powder that I didn't even know ever existed. So they are going to have a B10, which looks completely white, B20, B30, B40, and then they're adding B70 and a BD121. So now the loose powder, which used to be called translucent, but it was almost like a translucent 1, translucent 2, so on and so forth, they're adding darker shades. So if you are on the deeper side of the spectrum, you're going to be able to enjoy the loose powder from Chanel, which is amazing. It's about time. I love the Chanel loose powder. It's one of my favorite loose powders available. It is so light, it lasts forever. So this is very exciting to me. I'm very curious about that. Did I say B12? It looks like B12 is a new shade, and then they're discontinuing B22 and B25. I had no clue those ever existed. I am excited about the B12 because that should have a little bit more of a rosy undertone. That would be beautiful for setting the face. Same price, $52. It looks like it's shipping out to retailers in May, and then it's going to be in the beauty boutiques and on Chanel.com sometime in March. This next launch is really exciting. I don't know if there are any gentlemen watching or any ladies who know somebody who really loves the Boy de Chanel makeup collection, but they're coming out with some new products. There's going to be a fortifying gel moisturizer. This will retail for $80. It's going to be a mattifying daytime moisturizer for men. I think this looks really great. It has hyaluronic acid, green coffee extract, 94% natural ingredients. It comes in blue packaging, it's called Boy de Chanel, but if this sounds like something that you would like to wear, of course, this is really for everybody. All makeup is for everyone. So this looks really cool. There's also going to be a new stick concealer. It's Le Corrector, $45. It comes in 8 different shades. This is meant to minimize the appearance of dark circles, correct imperfections, and reduce the signs of fatigue. A long wear formula, up to 8 hours. I don't generally like a stick concealer, not underneath the eye, but I am curious about this for spots on the face. If it has a really great texture, this would be amazing to have for anybody. And I know my husband does ask me from time to time, I'm sort of outing him right now, but he will ask me for a little concealer if he has, you know, a little blemish or something going on his face. He tells me, like, help me, like, please do something. He would never buy this. I could buy this for him and he would probably use it in those cases that he does need something like this. But I think this is really interesting. And then there's also going to be Le Stylo Yeux 3-in-1, a little eyeliner. I don't think he would use that, but for guys who want a black, brown, or navy eyeliner, it's going to be made available to you. And then there are also a couple new nail polishes, Le Vernis. There's a new fragrance launching. This is so exciting. I know I mentioned this, I think, in an old Get Ready With Me video because I'd heard rumblings that this was coming. And sure enough, here it is. There's a new Les Eaux. It's the Paris Edinburgh. Keynotes include lemon and bergamot for freshness, juniper berry and cypress, and vetiver and cedarwood. This looks very interesting. Of course, all of the Les Eaux fragrances are inspired by water destinations that were important to Gabrielle Chanel. So I will be very curious to hear the story. I don't know the connection there, but everything they do has purpose and meaning, and there's a story. So I'm sure at some point, perhaps, Mademoiselle traveled to Edinburgh and it had some sort of impact on her. All of these are fresh, more cologne type of fragrances. This sounds like it could be more unisex. I'm interested. I'm very curious to smell it. Sure enough, I found the inspiration. I knew there had to be more to the story. It says, the most earthy, androgynous, and woody interpretation of Les Eaux de Chanel, inspired by a destination dear to Gabrielle Chanel. I guess that doesn't really tell us much. I knew that there must have been a connection. So clearly she visited Edinburgh. These photos look gorgeous. It definitely looks green. So if you love a green fragrance, this might be for you. But the fact that they say that it's earthy and androgynous and woody, this is going to lean a little bit more masculine. And it's shipping out to stores in June. It will be in the beauty boutiques and Chanel.com in May. They're coming out with a Chance Eau Tendre hair oil. This looks very interesting. It's going to retail for $60. It looks like a cute little bottle. Keynotes include jasmine absolue and a rose accord. It's enriched with jojoba oil to leave hair feeling soft, shiny, and light. It looks gorgeous. They have a couple different hair mists. There's a Gabrielle. There's a few others. I always see them whenever I go to the boutiques, but I don't own any of the hair mists. I think Eau Tendre would be a really nice fragrance for the hair. What else would be a good one? I think they have a Coco Mademoiselle. They should come out with a Coco Noir. That I would buy. And if you're still with me, the last thing we have to talk about is skincare. There are a couple new launches coming for the first half of the year. This one is really exciting. It's a Hydra Beauty Camellia Repair Mask. I love the Hydra Beauty line. It's a great skincare line for anybody who's dry. If you have parched skin and you really struggle to find something that hydrates you, Hydra Beauty is amazing. I also think it's a good introductory skincare line, but it doesn't necessarily have to be for somebody who's younger. My mom loves the gel cream. You know, in theory, she should be wearing probably Sublimage, but she just loves the texture. She thinks it's amazing, so she uses the gel cream and she loves it. It's for everybody. So this is going to retail for $55. It's also on the lower price point scale. The result and texture, it says it's deeply hydrating, it will strengthen the skin barrier, lock in moisture, ultra rich, generous balm texture. So this would be a sleep mask that you could wear probably a couple times a week, depending on how dry you are. 90% naturally derived ingredients. I love the direction they're going. This is amazing. It has the Camellia Alba PFA, the polyfractioned active, which is a patented technique. It's basically a clarification that they use to extract the purest form of the ingredients. It's something that I believe is patented by Chanel. It also has the Blue Ginger PFA, Camellia Wax, I'm not sure how I feel about that, and then Panthenol Pro Vitamin B5 to soothe and protect skin from water loss. And then the Camellia Wax, it says 100% plant-based, protects the skin barrier, nourishes the skin, and provides immediate comfort. So that doesn't seem so bad after all. I don't know, whenever I hear of wax, I don't know why that scares me a little bit. But I have skincare with beeswax, so I guess it's really not that big of a deal. And last but not least, there are some new Sublimage products, which they just released the cleansing collection not that long ago where they expanded the cleansers. So now we're gonna have La Crème Lumière and a La Lotion Lumière. The La Lotion is going to be a .com exclusive. It's light renewing exfoliating lotion. It retails for $150. I really like the original La Lotion. It's more of like a softening toner. It's really lovely. And then this cream looks interesting. This is for regeneration and brightening. This is gonna retail for $400. And I wanna say, I think that's the same price as the creams. Look at this new La Crème Lumière. What makes it different? This one has 88% naturally derived ingredients. It has vanilla planifolia PFA, which is to regenerate skin. It's the stem cells from the vanilla plant. It also contains a vanilla planifolia intense water to prevent cellular oxidation, anthelis extract, vegetal squalene, and shea butter. Squalene, am I saying that right? Probably not. This ingredient is the hottest thing in the skincare world right now. I don't know what happened. Who is marketing squalene, whatever?
Squalene.
Okay, so I was wrong. Squalene. Okay, according...
Squalene.
Okay, we get it. I recently had a facial, and the facialist, when she finished with my laser treatment, she applied a serum, and she said, oh, this has squalene in it. I can't even say it right, even when I already know. And I said, what is that? You have to tell me about it. And she said, it's basically like hyaluronic acid, but the particles, the molecules are so small that it can penetrate deeper in the skin. So this ingredient is going to be found in this new Sublimage cream. I haven't heard any word that they were getting rid of the original Sublimage cream or the original L'Essence serum. I don't think that is happening. I think they're just expanding the range and providing more options. Of course, if that changes, if I hear something, I will let you guys know, keep you posted. Somebody asked me the other day if I was using any products from the Sublimage range any longer, and I'm not. Not right now. I've used them all in the past. Not these new launches, not the Lumiere versions. But I have used Sublimage. I really like it. I loved the Le Fluide. It's a little bit lighter texture. I really like the lotion. I love the gel cleanser. It's really nice for removing makeup. But the moisturizer is just too heavy for my skin. I'm not there yet. It's a very intense moisturizer. My favorite product is definitely the eye cream. I think I've gone through maybe two or three of the Sublimage eye creams, and we're talking about over the span of years. Of course, I used to work at a counter, and I think I've received at least two of them were complimentary. I love the fact that Chanel is going in that direction of creating skincare that is a little bit more natural. They've always had great skincare. They've always included botanicals and natural ingredients. The research that they put into their skincare is absurd. When you go through training, you see how intense it is and how they work with dermatologists, and they're always on, you know, the edge of new technology, coming up with new ingredients. So it's really quite amazing. They never market themselves as being a technologically advanced skincare brand. That's not to say that they aren't putting in a ton of work behind the scenes. It's Chanel. They care about what they put out. It's not just the name. They really are committed to creating quality products. I'm excited about everything that's launching the first half of the year. I cannot wait to see the translucent powders, to see the new Cruise collection or the Summer Glow collection. These pieces are going to be so much fun. Let me know what you think down below in the comment section. What interests you? Are you excited about something? Are you not excited about something? What would you like to see coming out from Chanel? Is it sick that now I'm already thinking about holiday? Now that we've already previewed the first half of the year, I can't help it. I guess it's probably human nature that I'm like, okay, what's coming after that? Tell us the plan for 2021. No, it's bad. We need to have patience. That completes today's preview. I showed you everything. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this video and you liked seeing what's coming up next from Chanel. If you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. Leave me your comments, your questions down below. I love hearing from you guys. As always, I will be linking everything mentioned as soon as it's available. Everything on my face will be linked down below in the description box for your convenience. And for more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell.